Hello DBAs, I'm back again. Now in this lecture, we'll be understanding about how do you save your SQL worksheet data. Now you might have a requirement saying like, okay Arun, I run so many queries and then I just want to save my session so that I can refer to those queries later on in future. Great, you can do that. And sometimes you might have a requirement where you run some set of queries again and again against multiple schemas. So what you can do is you can write all those queries in one location, save those queries, and simply open the worksheet again and again to run against multiple schemas. Definitely you can do that, but for that you need to understand how do you save a SQL worksheet and how do you retrieve it. Okay, so now I have a connection that is hr@testdb. That is where I'm connected. What I'll do is I'll quickly run a couple of queries and then try to save our SQL worksheet. So select star from jobs and then select star from regions and then select star from countries. Okay, and let me try to run these queries one by one. And as I mentioned, highlight the query that you want to run and then click on this play icon and this will open up your tables. You can see this is the result area. This is where you get all the results. Now my requirement is to save this worksheet because I might run these queries again and again against this database. So what I'll do is you can click on this save icon. Can you see this one? Or you can press Ctrl S, click on the save icon, and this will allow you to save this SQL script. Can you see this actually stores your queries in the .sql format, right? So whatever the file name is, let's take, if you have some queries that you run every day morning. So morning at 10 a.m. queries, right? And then I'll probably save it on the desktop, click on save, done. Perfect. Now I'll close this tab. And now I want to run those queries again. So how do I open it? Go to file, click on open, and this will allow you to open the SQL file that we just saved. So where is our SQL file? What name we gave it? Morning. So morning, can you see this one? Morning 10 a.m. queries.sql. Click on open. All your queries are over there and then you can continue to run these queries one by one. Now it will ask you on which database you want to run. Now this is where you have to connect to the right schema on which you want to run. So I want to run it against the HR. I'll click on OK and done. This will give me the output of the jobs table. The same way I can run this query. And the same way I can run this query. Now let us try to run all the queries at once and see what happens. So if you select everything or press Ctrl A and click on this play icon, that means we need to get output of all the queries, right? All the three queries. Now, can you see this one? You have query result one. That is nothing but the output from the jobs table. The first query result is the default query result that we had earlier. So now you can see this one. If you just put your mouse, you will see a little pop-up which says select star from jobs. That's the result over there. And if you take your mouse over here, you can see select star from regions. That's the result for that query. And if you hover onto this third tab, it says select star from countries, and that's the result for your last query. And that's why I always say be very careful when you run queries inside the SQL developer. Don't do Ctrl A or click on this run button, because if in your SQL worksheet you have a couple of deletes, updates, modify statements, they will be re-executed against the table and that might create an impact. So be very careful when you run queries inside the SQL developer. Ultimately, guys, this is one of the simplest ways to save the queries. And in case if you want to share your queries with your friends, what you can do is run those queries, test those queries, whether they are working or not. If they are working fine, save your SQL worksheet and send that worksheet file to your friends. It's very easy and it actually simplifies the way you work onto your database. That's it for now, guys, and I'll see you in the next lecture.